I made a 3/4 wig. You probably got, I haven't made one in a while because I plan on leaving my hair out, mainly because a lot of people have been asking me how I wear weave with my hair being cut, and at the same time some people are asking me how to blend short hair with weave. So this will hopefully help to answer those questions. I decided not to cut the split in the middle yet because it's going to be easier for me to work with it and stuff. Just like right now, I can easily put it on without sewing it on yet. And I'm going to start off by parting off some hair to the front. I'm going to put this back part in a ponytail. Notice the ponytail is not tight, it's loose like that. The way I made this 3/4 wig, I know a lot of people are gonna ask me, make a video on how to make 3/4 wig, blah blah. I already made a video on how to make it a few years back, maybe 2011, 2012, I don't remember quite well. But I made this wig exactly the same way I made the wig in that video, so I'm gonna link the tutorial and the information bar so you guys can check it out. And the hair specs is going to be provided in the information bar. As always, I always provide hair information in the information bar as well as other information, so don't forget to check. So now I'm going to transfer the wig on a mannequin head so I can better work with it. I'm going to take this hair and cut the ponytail from underneath and cut it upwards. I'm gonna clean up the cut a little bit because it's kind of uneven right now. So I'm just basically gonna cut a couple layers to even things out. I'm gonna bump the hair some with a flat iron to help me better see the places where I still need to fix. Since I shaved off the sides of my head, I have no hair to sew on the sides and the back. But if you have hair, you can feel free to make another braid going. It's open, you can always flip the wig up and moisturize your hair and all that good stuff. And you can clip it down if you wish. You can sew clips on the inside and then clip it onto the braids that you're gonna make right here. But I'm gonna sew it down just because I like sewing better. I'm gonna be using some hair extension. Actually, I'm gonna cut this in half. And some people requested that I do a tutorial on how you braid hair with hair extension. I'll probably have to do another video on that. And I have a regular video on how to braid in general, just like cornrow, like simple cornrow. And I'm gonna link it in the information bar below.
Sometimes you leave her alone, but she know that she might need some. And don't worry if it's not perfect. It's not gonna be perfect. I mean, no one is gonna see the braid, so just do your thing. As long as the hair is braided somehow, you'll be fine.
Cause I'm a prisoner of love. Baby girl, come and tell her. Cause I will mend your broken heart.
And now I'm just gonna connect the two braids in the middle here.
We're gonna make my life complete. Baby, only you.
Okay, so now that you've got your U part braid, I know it looks so funny. If you have longer hair or you just have hair in general, you can braid the rest of your hair down, like going all the way back. You can do design if you want, which is absolutely not necessary. So I'm just gonna do my hair like that and put the U part on. And I'm gonna start sewing it down.
Looking truly cinematic. When she bent low, see the city made of magic. When she in the club, yes, the whole city panic. She got the grand sex, looking tight in the spandex. She tell me what she feel inside. She say it's something so deep and wide. If you want this, as bad as I do, girl, let me satisfy you. Baby, only you. My baby, only you. Where are the sea, where they make me the happy.
Okay, I am done. It's all sewn on. It's secure, it's not going anywhere. If your hair is too heavy, let's say you have longer hair, let's say you have like 10 packs of hair in your head and it's heavy as hell, you want to make sure to sew down the sides also, because it might weigh down your hair. Like when your hair starts to grow out in the middle here, it will start tugging on it and you don't want that. Or another way to also prevent hair breakage is to do it more often, like maybe like every 2 weeks when your hair starts to grow out a lot. To make blending more effortless, like make it easier, especially if you have shorter hair, I would glue one track of hair right here. It would make everything look fly. It wouldn't be like bumpy. Cause like, for example, right here, if I just use my hair to cover it, like it might not look all the way fly. When I just started doing my own hair, I wasn't very good at it. So whenever I do sewings, especially middle part sewings or side part or whatever, I would have like a big gap right here between the U part wig and my own hair. So like when I blend it, it would look funny and be a little bumpy in the front. And like right now, I can get away with just blending my hair without gluing any track and just, you know, placing it on top of the wig like that after flat ironing it, of course. But I like to, just to make everything look flatter and cleaner, and also helps with blending better when you have short hair. And the reason why gluing a piece in the front makes it look flatter is because like right here, it's a wig. It's like the hair is sewn on a cap, and then the hair and the cap is sewn on a braid. So it's like it's bulkier. But if you just have a glued down piece, it's just gonna be the hair glued closer to your scalp. So I hope you get the logic behind that. I'm gonna be using this Proclaim glue. And I know some people are scared of gluing hair onto their own head and all that stuff. I used to be scared too, but you don't have to be scared. Like, as long as you take it out properly, you have no problem. And there's a lot of tutorials that show you how to take out glue from hair on YouTube. You just have to search it. And also, since I'm only using it on a small portion of my head, I don't have much to worry about. Why is it not coming out though? But yeah, you don't have to do this step, like I said, if you're not comfortable gluing hair onto your head. And I'm just applying a very thin layer onto the weft. If you're gluing it on a larger section of your head, or you just want to be more secure, they have like things that you use to protect your hair when you glue hair on. You can buy that at Sally Beauty Spy Store. I don't remember exactly what it's called, but I don't have it and I'm not worried. And for those people that kept asking me why I cut my hair, I cut it because I got sick of it. Like, the longer it got, the more annoying it got to like take care of it and shit. And I wasn't having that. And besides, I barely wear that anyway. So what's the point of having it if, yeah. But anyway, and I don't value hair that much, it's just hair. Like, some people are like, oh my god, you cut your hair. Oh, chill out, it's my hair. And hey guys, I'm not being rude, this is just how I am. I'm just, you know, goofy like that. Because I feel like a lot of times when I say some things, people get offended, but my intention is not to be rude, okay? And I like it, it's easier to maintain. And I ain't got nothing to worry about. I just wake up, comb my hair, wash it from time to time, and that's it. And I don't have plans of growing it out anytime soon. So now, you don't want to glue it exactly to your scalp. You just kind of glue it like close to where you sew the wig on. Oh my god. I was supposed to wait like a few seconds for the glue to get tacky, but I didn't. Oh well. Still gonna work. And also, even if you have longer hair and you don't want to leave too much of your hair out, if you just want like a little leave out to furthermore prevent too much breaking with your own hair, like with flat iron and all that, gluing that one last track on will also help, because it's like you're using that track to create more hair that you can use to blend with the wig. I have to cut like some layers around here, like across the top here. And oh yeah, before I move on, like the way that I make my wigs nowadays, especially when I'm using a closure, I usually sew some hair underneath the cap right here so that it will not let this part show. I didn't do that this time because I don't know, I just did it. But if you want to do that, you can also do that to conceal the cap so that you wouldn't see the cap. Let's say if the wind blows back, all you're gonna see is hair, not hair and cap. You feel what I'm saying? And I'm gonna cut it downward. From notjustokay.com.